What up, YouTube? It's your boy Adam Specialist. So it was a good episode. There was some information to talk about, so let's get right to it. We got some pretty good information about Asta's demon form, and the way that he was able to use it is by using his key detection to learn more about his body and how his anti-magic swords work. So it was a pretty interesting moment to see how the anti-magic energy go through and flows through his body so that he can transform. Obviously, we know that by the tournament he'll be able to control his form because we saw him using it in the opening. So in some way he'll be able to control his demon form that's called Black Asta. That's how Leopold called him. So I guess it's official, it's Black Asta. But yeah, man, it was pretty cool to see his demon form once again, since I think the last time that we saw it was against the Queen of the Witches and everything. So it'd be cool to see Asta finally take control of this form and using it by himself and not by someone other than himself, like the Queen of Witches. So like I said, Asta can transform into his demon form, but he cannot control it yet. The only thing that he can do is transform into it. And obviously, the anti-magic sword are attracted, I guess, by magic. So the reason why he couldn't really control it is because his demon form was attracted to the biggest source of magic. And I guess this source was Leona-sama. Lady Leona. So I guess Leona-sama is the strongest character on the volcano right now, stronger than Yami, stronger than Charlotte of the Blue Rose and everything. So that's kind of interesting. Now I'm wondering when he'll be able to control this form, because I really want to see the extent of his power in the demon form. We haven't seen a lot yet. We only saw him fight when the Queen of Witches was kind of controlling him. So I really want to see the extent of his power in the tournament. It's soon, I think it begins next week's and next week's episode. So it's really, really soon. Even though the Black Asta part of the episode was really, really interesting, the thing that I was the most interested in was Noelle and Lady Leona and their discussion. But before I talk about that, I just want to say that for a moment I really thought the ladies and the men were going to bath together. So that was kind of funny when I don't remember her name, but one of the Blue Rose Knights kind of put up a wall so that the woman and the men would be separated. So that was really, really funny in my opinion. And even when the men were trying to peep the woman, you know, that was really, really funny in my opinion. But anyway, just to see Noelle and Lady Leona talk with each other, and Leona just talking about Noelle's mother and how they look like each other and everything, and how strong her mother was really, really nice. Because Noelle, nobody really talks about her mother, you know, nobody in her family. Obviously, we know that her brothers and sister dislikes her because they think that she's the reason that their mother died, and we haven't heard about her father yet. So that's pretty much the first time that she's heard about her mother and her mother's past. So Lady Leona said that Lady Asinor's mother was stronger than her, and she basically said that Lady Asi was the complete opposite from Noelle. Lady Asi is talented, she knows how to control her mana and everything, and Noelle is the complete opposite. She's not really talented, she doesn't know how to control her mana. So that was a pretty interesting. And Lady Leona also said that she wants Noelle to surpass her mother, you know. So now Noelle kind of has a goal. I don't know if she had a goal before this episode. We know that Asta wants to become the Wizard King. Now Noelle kind of has a goal. She now wants to become and surpass her mother, Lady Asi. So that was really, really interesting, man. And I really like the kind of armor, the Asie armor that Lady Asie has right now. That was kind of a magic, I guess. But yeah, man, she looks really, really strong. And hopefully we'll see more flashback of her mother, you know. I guess the only differences physically that they have, Noel and Lady Asie, is that Lady Asie has some kind of health ears, and she can use Asie magic instead of Noel having normal ears and using water magic or something like that. So that's also a pretty interesting fact, that Lady Asie kind of has elf ears, but we'll see maybe in the future of the series. And I guess that maybe Noel can use a water armor or something like that, so she can look like her mother. So that will be really, really interesting. But anyway, the last thing that I want to talk about is Fugelion, and I just want to say that it's crazy how he's still unconscious since he was defeated by the Eye of the Midnight Sun. He's still unconscious, man, and it's kind of crazy to me. It's been a while. I don't know how much time has passed in the anime right now, but for us it's been a while, you know, so hopefully he'll be able to recover. I don't know if he'll become again the captain of the Crimson Lion Kings, but we'll see. We saw Leon Sama in today's episode also, and we haven't seen much from him. We know that he'll become stronger, you know, he'll surpass maybe Fugelion. That's what Yami said, so we'll have to see in the future of the series. But yeah, man, hopefully we'll see more Fugelion in the future. Now next week begins the tournament for the special Kingsguard or something like that. I don't remember, the Royal Knights or something. So yeah, man, it's gonna be an interesting arc. It's gonna be a really good arc. It's kind of the Chunin exam arc for the Black Clover anime, so I'm hype about that. But yeah, man, it was a really good episode, especially for the moment where Noel talked with Lady Leona about her mother and Asta's demon form. So this was really, really interesting. Let me know what you thought about this week's episode in the comments down below, and let me know what you think is gonna happen next in the series, in the anime series, you know. So my bad if I sound bad right now. I'm really, really sick. I live in Canada, so the winter is really harsh. It's really, really cold right now, so I'm gonna try to get better. But yeah, man, this, like I said, this was a pretty good episode of Black Clover. I'm hyped for the tournament, and I really want to know how they will execute this tournament. Sometimes it doesn't work, sometimes it does, so we'll have to see. Thank you for watching. I do Black Clover reviews every Tuesday, so subscribe for that. And I do other anime related things like the Promised Neverland reviews on Thursdays, Fairy Tail, One Piece, and Sword Art Online reviews on Saturdays, and when the filler will be over and when the anime catch up to the manga, there will be a Boruto Naruto Next Generation reviews on Sunday, so stay tuned for that. Follow me at Anime Specialin on Instagram and Twitter, just to talk, you know, about anime or to have more information. Like I said, follow me at Anime Specialist on Twitter and Instagram. But yeah, man, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Anime Specialist out. Peace.